Flight leader, Second Lieutenant Joseph Peter Rapuson.
In a short while, we shall witness some. maneuver, timing, and high precision. These trainer aircraft are utilized in the basic phase of military pilot training. The flight is led by Captain Rodolfo N. Mahaya Jr., Squadron Commander of 102nd Basic Pilot Training Squadron, and by Colonel Sonny Lin, PFGSC, Chief of Command Staff, AEC.
Through this full dress ceremony, we are observing the 65th founding anniversary of the Philippine Air Force. We are not only commemorating 65 years of gallant service to flag and country by all airmen, but we are also dedicating ourselves to the future for the next 10 to 15 years, if only to better serve as vanguards of our nation's skies. In welcoming you, I find it fitting, therefore, that we gather here at the Air Education and Training Command, Fernando Air Base, Tipa City, the gateway to military service in our country and main anvil of our pilots in aviation. It is only right today to that we not only have personnel and unit information, but we shall also have Air Force planes on flyby, which compose of our modest air assets. Matagal-tagal na rin panahon ang dumaan na hindi tayo nakakapagita ng flyby, and the aerial passage today symbolizes the power of possibilities which was made possible by our Almighty Father. Thank God the sun is up in shining radiantly today. God has always been generous with his blessings to the Air Force and to the Air Force family. Those space information later also represent our collective will and determination to maintain our focus on our primary mission, to return to the basics, and to set things right for our organization. And to set things right, we need to primarily show that we are not expanding to become a ground force, rather we are powering up to project air power in service to our country and people. Likewise, the composite flights embodies our untiring zeal and effort to modernize our fleet and to show positive results, not only for the sake of supporting NDP operations, but for the higher value of sustaining the dreams of our young flyers in the next generation. So, for this 65th anniversary, those planes are not incidental. They form our centerpiece. They bear our ideals. They are our rallying points. For the past year, the story of the Philippine Air Force could not be seen and measured to the 23,000 hours we flew alone, nor could it be explained by the almost 5 million pounds of cargo our different wings bore across the sun, Visayas, and Mindanao. As a matter of fact, there is more to them than meet the eyes. First, beyond numbers, there has been force multiplication by our flying units whenever a type of tactical aircraft would serve the equivalent of one army company or battalion. We also multiplied our support units when our special operations team consistently disrupted enemy actions or influence build-up, particularly in the Calabarzon area, or when our intelligence operative helped in neutralizing threats in Mindanao. Second, there has been operational transcendence, much less in quality and safety, such as when our C-130 helicopters saved numerous lives by searching for survivors and flying in non-stop relief operations in the aftermath of Typhoon Sendong, especially in Cagayan de Oro City. Third, there has been the ripple effect of our non-traditional engagement in our bayanihan for peace, which has won over new partners and supporters as we help reforest mountains, replenish land for desperate patients, clean up rivers, manage waste, build shelters with the habitat for humanity, and with Gawad Kalina, warm the hearts of orphans and aged in nursing homes, and engage the service and youth leaders in many notable projects. Fourth, there has been our sustained peacekeeping mission abroad in Syria, Israel, Sudan, Ivory Coast, East Timor, Pakistan, India, the colonized Liberia in particular, which helps strengthen our government's contribution to unite to the United Nations in many areas of humanitarian crisis. Fifth, there has been organizational reform whose impact has spread down the ranks as we sustain programs to further deepen our core values, strengthen discipline, and build anti-corruption measures, account for unit performance, measure leadership effectiveness, and chart a strategic path through our quasar and power-up approaches. Six, there has been the start of a focused capability transformation through the implementation of the defense system of management, which has allowed the Air Force this time to systematically lay the bricks toward a more robust and responsive Air Force. Now, we are most eager to soar higher with the planned acquisitions of 3 radar systems and several prime assets within the next 2 to 3 years, such as 21 utility helicopters, 10 attack helicopters, 4 more search and rescue helicopters, 2 long-range patrol aircraft, a special mission aircraft, 3 medium lift aircraft, and 12 lead-in fighter aircraft. And 7th, there has been a strategic recasting of our tools, gears, geared towards meeting the challenges of a rapidly changing threat environment, which has resulted in the revision of our doctrines, the formulation of working arrangements with other agencies, the growing of new basing and education plans, the remapping of our stations, evaluation of new systems, and heightened air power advocacy among all stakeholders. All of these, ladies and gentlemen, couldn't be captured in numbers, but they have found better expressions in the acts of our airmen, the greater majority of whom serve out there in the field in the face of danger. Your airmen are the ones who give real substance for our celebration today. Their faith, discipline, dedication, continuing sacrifice, in fact, have made this day special for all of us. With all my heart, then, I thank all the men and women of the Philippine Air Force for their individual and collective achievements for the whole anniversary year. Nagpapasalamat din po ako sa mga pamilya ng ating mga sundalo sa kanilang patuloy na pagbibigay sa ating samahan ng inspirasyon at lakas. At lalo ako nagpapasalamat sa inyong lahat na mga kaibigan ng hukong ipapawid sa inyong pagdalo sa espesyal na araw nito. At si Commanding General of the Air Force, I am very thankful for the precious time you are spending with us today, and I wish to express the hope that as we renew our commitment to patriotic service, you, our friends, will remain steadfast in partnership with us in forging our shared path to the future. On this 65th anniversary, I ask that we face this year and the next with a strong heart and a clear head to effect our transformation. My friends, on the 65th year, the Philippine Air Force issued Bagwis ng Kapayapaan, Tagapagtanggol ng Kalayaan, your wing of peace, defenders of freedom. It is our team. It is our aim. It is our rallying call. We know that it is your aspiration. Let us therefore join hands in celebration today, as well as recognition of the core that binds us together, our dreams of our Air Force and the liberation of all airmen. In every way and to every extent possible, let us share our time, talents, and treasures so that your Air Force will rise true to its calling. Valiant in our first line of defense, invaluable in peace, and valorous in any life-saving mission. With that, I once again welcome you all. Binabati ko po kayong lahat ng isang maligayang 145 karawan ng ating hukong ipapawid. God bless our Air Force. God bless us all.
Distinguished guests, our awardees whose commendable achievements merit our nation's recognition in this ceremony, the ever-patriotic officers, men and women, and civilian employees of the Philippine Air Force, fellow workers and government, ladies and gentlemen. In reiteration of my advance greetings during your Air Power Symposium 2 weeks ago, I now humbly convey my warmest congratulations to the Philippine Air Force family as you commemorate your 65th founding anniversary today. Let me also greet all of our awardees this morning. Your outstanding deeds have greatly contributed to the attainment of the mission of your proud command. Without doubt, you are truly deserving of the honor accorded to you by the thankful Filipino nation within the modest means of your Defense Department. Let us give a big hand to our awardees. My personal greetings likewise go to these officers, airmen and women and civilian employees of the Philippine Air Force on this most welcome occasion of your Foundation Day. Many of them are not with us now, but they are in our air bases and stations, in our airfields and airstrips, in our aircraft on air operations, and they are performing their duties without question. Some of them are in distant islands and islets of our archipelago, be it in West Philippine Sea, or in Sulu or Tawi-Tawi, they do not cease to perform their duties in utter oblivion and anonymity. Personal dedication, sacrifice, and perseverance characterize the real state of our Philippine Air Force personnel in the execution of their constitutional task and responsibility. Let us clap for the pilots, airmen, and civilian employees of the Philippines. Our Air Force has been humbly devoting its very limited resources in support of the constitutional duty of our armed forces to protect our people and secure the sovereignty of our state and the integrity of our national territory. For 65 years, the commitment and dedication to duty of its officers and men and women have been beyond question. The courage and patriotism of our pilots and airmen have been manifested in their readiness to undertake any air operation mission and their willingness to offer the supreme sacrifice whenever necessary. Our Philippine Air Force has been into both traditional and non-traditional roles. Its functions involve the pursuit of all forms and facets of our national endeavors, be it political, social, or economic. Our Air Force has been anywhere and everywhere in our country and our territorial borders and domains. Our aircraft and pilots are either in patrol and combat operations, in security coverages, or vital assets and installations. In airlift runs of personnel, supplies and equipment, in search, rescue and rehabilitation missions during the advent of disasters and calamities, in the transport of the sick and wounded, and in countless errands in the name and for the good of our endeared Republic. Nevertheless, the job of the Philippine Air Force cannot be done by determination and enthusiasm of our Air Force personnel alone. We need to have potent and reliable air platforms for our air skippers and crew to operate and fly. As ever, we have been relentless in our goal of acquiring new and potent replacements for our old and unreliable air assets. And we are now very determined in our intention to modernize. The vital and expeditious goal of modernizing our Air Force and our armed forces, for that matter, has been the serious consideration of our national leadership. It has become a must in our pursuit of many operational plans and endeavors for internal peace, security, and stability. Our extreme necessity to modernize is likewise meant to address the primordial constitutional duty of our armed forces to secure the sovereignty of the state and the integrity of the national territory. I am happy to let you know that through our defense system of management, the upgrade and modernization program of our armed forces is presently on full swing. This is limited. This is limited only by the maximum amount of financial resources that our government can afford to allocate. Your Defense Department is now working swiftly on the approval of the contracts for the 130 upgrade and modernization projects of our armed forces to be implemented over the next 5 years. The deadline that we have set for ourselves for the approval of all these contracts is on July 31, 2020, 2 weeks from now. These projects will surely provide the Philippine Air Force with brand new and reliable air assets for its air operations, along with the operational requirements of the Philippine Navy and the Philippine Army. This includes, among others, the acquisition of surface attack aircraft leading fighter trainer, attack helicopters, light transport aircraft, and medium transport aircraft, all of which are expected to be delivered within 2 years from now. These are in addition to the 4 multi-purpose combat utility helicopters of the Sokol that are scheduled to be delivered within this year. The placement of these assets in our Air Force inventory shall surely boost its air operations capability. The availability of these aircraft shall once and for all erase the ironic and naughty commentary that our present Air Force is all air devoid of force. With these humble reflections, I wish to congratulate the Philippine Air Force for its unwavering obedience to our constitutional mandate, even as I commend its officers, men and women, and civilian employees for their ever-burning patriotism for our beloved Philippines. It is very encouraging to note that you have so eloquently reaffirmed your love for our country in your team. Philippine Air Force at 65, Bagwis ng Kapayapaan, Tagapagtanggol ng Kalayaan. General Cruz, thank you for your invitation, and before something serious happens to me, I forgot to greet my best friend and President Bagwis, Rodona. Happy anniversary, thank you.
And of course, right here is Second Lieutenant Andy James Ricardo.
Thank you. This is it. Model the 3rd Squadron.
Once again, may we request everyone to focus their attention about the left of the horizon and view the largest aircraft of the Philippine Air Force. All of which are instrumental in the accomplishment of the Philippine Air Force mission and the performance of its essential function. We need the formation of the Wildcats with a 231 Bravo and Delta aircraft.
Of the 30th Presidential Earth Wing.
This
is the high level of efficiency and polished airmanship of the pilots of the Philippine Air Force, which the organization puts a premium on. Once again, let us give them a round of applause. Flag is ready to reverse as a salute to all airmen and women of the Philippines.